Welcome to Cutting It Close, a channel where we talk woodworking technology, a little bit of business, and make some cool projects. In today's video, I'm going to talk about an unusual way that I marketed my products when I was first starting out that made me about $25,000, and it could be a really good business idea for you. So let's get right into it. So where did I market my stuff? I marketed my stuff at charity and benefit auctions. Now, before you think, well, how did you make money and market your stuff at charity and benefit auctions? That seems kind of messed up, right? Let me explain. First, let me go over what's a charity or benefit auction, right? And, you know, maybe it's just particular to small town USA or small town Texas. I don't know if it's in other countries, but where I'm at, there's so many little small auctions that may benefit a local fire department, somebody that's been sick, a church, a school, some kind of after school program. There's a number of reasons people host these charity events or these little benefits, right? And typically, you know, I'm from a small town, so I see them a lot. I don't know about a big city, and I don't know about other countries, but where I'm from, these happen all the time, okay? Well, I marketed and made stuff for these charity auctions, or I marketed my stuff at these charity auctions. Now, let me show you how I kind of sold stuff to these auctions to get it in there to market my products. It's kind of a weird scenario, but let me go over the business transaction of how I was able to get my stuff in front of thousands and thousands of people's eyes and actually make money while doing it. Well, typically there's a lot of people that have to donate to these auctions. Maybe it's a specific business write-off. I mean, some businesses have to donate X amount of money a year, or some people, maybe a local state representative or a local elected official. It's election year and they're trying to get reelected, so they're donating money, getting their name out there. Or it's an insurance agent or a real estate agent. Well, they take, let's say, $1,000 or $500 or $5,000, and they take that $1,000 and usually write that auction a check. Or they go out and, or write that benefit a check, right? They go out and write X, Y, and Z benefit. Let's call it Little Susie's charity benefit, right? So they write $1,000 to Little Susie's charity benefit. Well, I came in and I stepped in there and said, hey, X, Y, and Z person, instead of writing that $1,000 check to Susie Q's benefit auction, buy $1,000 of stuff from me. Let me put that stuff in the auction under your name or let you donate it, right? And then at the auction, whenever that stuff sells, it's going to bring more than $1,000. It might bring $2,000. It might bring $1,500. In some cases, he would buy $1,000 worth of stuff from me and it would bring $6,000. You don't know what's gonna happen at these auctions, okay? So these guys used to buy $1,000 or however much money from me, and then they would donate it, still donate, they still can use that $1,000 as a write-off, right? And then they would donate it, and instead of writing a check, they would donate, maybe I make a table or a coffee table or a swing or a bench, or here's some of my past projects that I made right here, and I put them in auctions, right? And I would donate this, and the auctioneer would say, hey, this has been donated by so-and-so local future elected official right here, but it was made by Ryan and Ryan's company. Look how nice it is, oh my gosh. And then you have people starting to bid on it, and then they see it, and you have your business cards on it, and people are taking your business cards. All the while, somebody actually bought that table from you already. Right, so it's already paid for, you already made your money on it, and now you're getting free advertising, and then you may make some projects and they are complete bust and nobody even wants them. You don't have to, and you go, well, let's not make that. Maybe I thought that design was cool, but it didn't work out. And maybe you think some design's not very good, I did this multiple times, and you put it in the auction and end up bringing a lot of money because everybody loved it. So then if a whole bunch of people are bidding on it at this live auction or this silent auction, you know, okay, this is a really good product. What if I sold this to more people, okay? So this whole transaction right here is, nobody really talks about it. It's very unique, but if you can talk to these agents or businesses that donate money, it's a giant win-win scenario across all boards because they're donating money, so they're winning. It actually brings more than what they were gonna donate to the charity or to the benefit. So the benefit's winning and you're also winning. So if you pitch them the idea, they will do it 9 times out of 10. And what starts to happen then is that guy not only does one auction a year, right? He may do 3 or 4. that he benefits to, or say auctions, a charity, right? Some kind of charity benefit that he actually donates to 3 or 4 times a year. Well, then you get 2 or 3 different people doing that, and annually you know that there's an auction on August 13th, and another benefit on May 13th, and another one on September the 28th, right? And you know it's coming, and you know they need $1,000 of stuff from you. So you can build it a month in advance, 2 months in advance, or if you're like me, you build it the night before and you barely get it done in time, even though you've known about it for 3 months. But those kind of, that unique strategy is, I'm telling you, it's a great business idea. I've made, annually, I was making at least $25,000 a year off these auctions, and that's not even including what I've got from it, from residual effect of people buying stuff from that auction or buying, taking my business card and wanting to buy something from me in the future. So I hope this explanation helped. I hope it kind of opened your eyes to a unique way of marketing and selling your products. I hope you left this video with more knowledge than when you started. Give this channel a subscribe, give this video a like, and don't forget to leave the comments in the comment sections below. And once again, if you ain't cutting it close, you ain't cutting it right.